Okay, proceeding further, we come to problem number 13 of exercise 7.9. Here you are having I is equal to integral from 2 to 3 x upon x square plus 1. Now in this case, you can clearly see that in the numerator you are having x and the denominator you are having x square plus 1. Okay, derivative of x square is 2x and derivative of 1 is 0. So we can say that x square plus 1 is having a part of the derivative present in the numerator. So what you will do in the next step, you multiply by 2 and divide by 2. Okay, this is the multiplication part, this is the division part. Why we have did so? To adjust the derivative. Okay, now we can write this as 2 to 3 x square plus 1 dash upon x square plus 1 dx. Okay, now you can apply our formula. This gives you 1 by 2 log mod x square plus 1. Okay, log mod x square plus 1 and within limits 2 to 3. This is 1 by 2 common. Apply the upper limit, which is 3. You get log of 3 square is 9. 9 plus 1, 10. Minus, apply the lower limit 2. 2 square is 4. 4 plus 1 is 5. You get this. And finally, you can write this as 1 by 2 log of 10 by 5. That gives you 1 by 2 log. Okay. Quite easy one. We are using this formula. Integral from f dash, integral f dash x upon fx dx. This gives you log mod fx. Okay. Clear? We have used this formula here. Okay. Proceeding further, we come to this question. Now in this case, remember one thing. No need to apply u into v rule. Here, no need to apply u into v rule because you don't know what is the integral of e raised to x square. Okay, so what you have to do, you can see for the power of e, you are having x square, unusual term. Okay, means we can proceed with doing the substitution. Okay, and delta of x square is 2x, which is present here. So what you will do, put x square equal to t. This gives you 2x is equal to dt by dx, and this gives you x dx equal to dt by 2. Okay, now remember one thing, zero and one, these are the limits of x. Here you are integrating with respect to x, so 0 and 1, these are the limits of x. Okay, what you have to do, you have changed the variable, so you have to change the limits also. Lower limit of x is 0. And what you have taken? You have taken t as x square. If you put 0 here, you will get t is equal to 0. And upper limit is 1. If you put 1 here, 1 square is 1. You get this. Okay. No doubt, here you are getting the values of the limits of t also as 0 and 1 only. Okay. Now this gives you I is equal to integral 0 to 1. This time, this 0 to 1, these are limits of t. Okay. This x dx, this turns out to be dt by 2. And e raised to x square, it becomes e raised to t. So this is 1 by 2 integral from 0 to 1 e raised to t dt. This gives you 1 by 2 e raised to t. Integral of e raised to t is e raised to t. Limits 0 to 1. Apply the upper limit. You get e raised to 1 and lower limit e raised to 0. And this gives you 1 by 2. This is e minus 1. Okay. Clear? In case of substitution, you have to change the limits of new variable. You have to change the limits from old variable to new variable. Okay. One more thing. When you solve this, here you can see you are getting the answer, but there is no need to come back to the original variable x. Okay. Why? Because we have already changed the limits of x, and now we are having the limits of new variable t. Okay. Definite integral में हम वापस old variable x में आते थे. यहाँ पे वापस old variable x में आने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. You have to